It is the third lecture in the fourth module of object-oriented design and programming. So in the first two lectures we discussed about the Java files, and in the second lecture is about the input and output stream classes. So in this lecture we are going to discuss about the character stream classes in Java. Okay, so we have used the input stream classes to read and write data in the form of bytes. So we can use the input stream classes to write byte data into the files or into the destination, and we can read the source data in form of bytes by using the input stream classes. So input and output stream classes are used to read and write data by using byte classes. So why we need character stream classes? We have, because already we have the input stream classes. So what is the purpose of why we need the character stream classes? Today the many applications are uses Unicode. So all of you know about that. So the Unicodes are available in different formats, encoding formats, UTF-8, UTF-16 and UTF-32, in which the commonly used encoding scheme is the UTF-8. And all these three encoding schemes requires has 4 bytes of data, and there is some variations. In Unicode 32 format we need the 4 byte data to represent a character. Unicode 16 minimum of 2 byte and maximum of 4 byte, which is required to represent the data. Unicode 8 minimum of 1 byte and maximum of 4 bytes. So all these three encoding schemes are maximum 4 byte size to represent the data, and all the characters are represented by using these encoding schemes. So maybe if you are using a Unicode 16 format, it is used to it uses 32 2 byte data to represent a character. So it's input and output streams are only supports read and write 1 byte data at a time, which is not required to manipulate the character stream classes, character stream data. So to solve this problem we are using the character stream classes. So character stream classes are mainly used to read data in the form of characters from a source, and also we can write the characters into a destination. As we have two kinds of character stream classes, a reader class and a writer class, similar to the input stream class and the output stream class. So reader class is a subclass of an abstract class which is used to read character streams from a data source. The data source may be a file, a console, a memory or anything. So we can read data from a source, character data from a source by using the reader class, which is similar to the input stream class. And the writer class, we can write data into a file, a memory or console by using this writer class, a character data. So we are writing and reading data in form of characters. So the first we'll look into the details of Java reader class. So Java reader class is available in java.io.reader package, and this is the base class for all the subclasses of Java IO application, all the reader subclasses of Java IO applications. In the figure you can see that we have different types of subclasses are available in reader class, like input stream reader, buffered reader, file reader, string reader, pipe reader. So different types of subclasses are there in the reader for different functionalities. If you want to read it from the file, we can use the file readers. If you want to read it from the console, then we can use the buffered reader. So similarly, based upon the source of data, we have different types of reader subclasses. So it's similar to Java input stream, except that in Java input stream we are using the byte form of data to read. So here we are using the character form, mostly it's in the Unicode format, UTF format. And the methods, which is similar to the methods available in the input stream class, we have different methods. So read methods, read the first method which reads a character from the one character from a data, and if you want to read a character byte, can use the second read methods, and similar to the other input stream classes and output stream class, we have a close method also to close the stream. So we'll look into details in the coming slides. And the second writer class, so which is available in the java.io.writer package, similar to the reader class. Here the writer class also have different subclasses like output stream writer, buffered writer, file writer, print writer. If you want to write into a file, we can use the file writer. And if you want to write into a console, then we can use the buffered writer. Okay, so similar to the output stream, which is similar to the output stream. In output stream, we can write it in the form of byte data, but here we can write it in the form of character data. And these are the methods which is available in the writer class. All these are abstract methods. We can implement it in the subclasses. So write in C, write the character array, then close, then the flush methods. So these are the some of the methods which is available in the writer class. Okay, so in the reader class, we are going to first discuss about the Java file reader. So Java file reader class is available in the package java.io.filereader. As I already told that data, if you want to read data from a file in the character format, we can use the file reader form. So we can read a data. We can read a data in the character format by using the file reader class. So file reader class, by using the file reader class, we can read the data from a character file text file in the form of character. So this works similar to the file input stream. In the input stream class, we have a subclass named file input stream class, and that file input stream class we have used to read the data from a file in our previous lecture. So similarly, the file reader also used to read data from the file, but in the form of characters. Sometime, as I already told, that the character may be represented in different for size and different formats. So any type of format or any type of size of data can handle by using the file reader. Usually in Java we are using the 2-byte to represent. 2-byte Unicode is used to represent the character data, right? So this is an example for the Java reader. So it is similar to the file input reader. We are going to create an object reference of the reader. So the reader object reference by using the file reader, then we are using the read method to read one by one character from the file. And the reader.close, which is a method which is available in the reader class and which is implemented here, which is used to close the file stream we have created. We'll look into the details of this program by using the Eclipse platform. So next, what are the constructors which is available in the file reader class? So in the constructors, these are the two main constructors which is available in the file read class, which is similar to the input file input stream class, and the difference is here we are going to read the character format. So we can give argument as a string file name or as a file name. I have already discussed about in the second video that we, based upon our the data which is available in our hand before the file read operations, if the data is available in the string format, we can use the first constructor to create the file reader. If the data is already available in the file is all in the file format, we can use the second constructor. And these two constructors will create file not found exception. There's a chance that we are going to read a file which is not already available in the system. So if you are going to refer a file, if you are trying to open a file which is not available, then it will generate the file not found exception. So we have to handle it in the program. And the methods which is available in the file read class are, it is a simple read method which returns an integer which represents the character. So if you want to read a byte of data, a bunch of data, then we can use the character array. And if you want to read a data and if you want to write it in the particular position in the character array, we can use this function. And the skip function, which is used to skip the particular number of characters in a file. Okay, next we can look into the details of these methods using the Eclipse platform. So this is an example for the simple read method. How the simple read method works in file reader. Okay, so you have to import a java.io.file to handle the file. Then it will create, sometimes it may create file not found exception. So we have to import the file not found exception class package. Then file reader. Then there is a chance that this method creates an IO exception. So we are going to handle the IO exception also in this program. And all this handled by using this statement. So we throw IO exception and file not found exception. If any exception which has happened within the program, it is thrown. So it will not terminate the program. As if all of you know that about the exception in Java. So we are going to open a file. So we are going to create a file. We created a file object. So already the file is there because we have used the second file constructor method, and we pass that file name of the file into here. So this is the second way of creating a file, a file reader, the second constructor method. Instead of giving a string, we can give a file name. So we can directly give a string file name here also. So the file reader is created. So now the reader is an object reference to the file reader and which points to the file input.txt. So input dot, the read method reads one by one character from a file, and we are printing the character. As we discussed in the previous video lecture, it returns -1. -1 means it is reached at the end of the file. So we can read one by one character from the file till it reaches -1. So -1 means, so we are using a while loop to iterate through the file, and in the while loop we are just printing the data. So because the reader.read statement reads one byte at a time, one character at a time, and it advances to the next character, it automatically advances to the next character. So we don't need to increase it in the while loop. Okay, and after printing all the statements, we are going to complete, we are going to close the string. Okay, so already I have already created a file. This is the input file which I have created. So it just displays, just have a content like welcome to the world of Java. This is a file read example. This is the content which is available in the input file, and we are going to read this content by using the read statement, read method. Okay, so next we can run this program. So we are going to run this program. Yeah, so this is the output. So we read the content from the file input file input.txt by using the read method. So it is read one by one at a time, and we use the while loop to iterate to the entire statement. Okay, so if we if I not use this file, then it will only generate returns one character at a time. So it returns one character, and we use a while loop to iterate to the entire character. So this is the first method which is available in the file reader class, the read method. Okay, I think it's clear now. Suppose if you want to read all the data in a single statement, we can use the second read method which is available in the file reader class. Okay, so this is an example for the second read method which is available in the file reader class. So we can read the data in one at a time, as a whole into the character array. So similar to the previous example, here also we have to import the file class, then file not exception class. If we are going to read a file which is not existing, then it generates a file dot exception class. I will demonstrate it. If I am going to create an input1.txt, the input1.txt is not available in my system, and I am going to run this, so it generates the exception. It generates the file not found exception because the input1.txt is not available in my system. So it generates the exception, so which is handled by using the file not found exception. Okay. Okay. So here, instead of the while loop, we read the character by using a single statement. So by using this single statement, we can read the character, all the characters in the. This statement is used to create the character array. So we created a 100 size, a character size of 100. This character array, CS character array, CS has an array size of 100. And by using a single statement, we can read all the characters into the character array. So here the CS is our character array, which is capable of storing 100 characters. So we can use this statement to read all the characters in the file. And next we are going through the character set and we are going to print it. So we can represent different way. We can use a different way to print the character. If you want, one method is we can convert it into a string and we can print it, because it is character, it reads data as a character into the file, it's not a string. So if you want to print the character, we have to use an iterate through the for loop. Otherwise we have to convert this character array into a string. So by different methods we can print it. So here we are using the for each method. By using the for method, I have iterated through the character array one by one, and the print just print the characters. So different methods we can use to print the data. So this is the method I have used here. I have iterated to the character array one by one by using this statement, and this is print the character. So when we print this, execute this statement again, it shows all the characters from the array. So this is the character from the array. We have created 100 character array of size 100, so that the remaining spaces looks like this. So we have only data up to this in the file, but we created a character size of 100 in the character array, so it displays like this. Okay. So this is the method. This is the most efficient method than the previous one, because read one by one characters, to read the whole character at a time is better than read one by one character. So see, this is the second read method which is available in the file reader class. And the third method, if you want to read only specific characters, only specific characters from a file, then we can use this method. Okay, so now I think all of you clear about these import statements. So I directly move into the section. Okay, so this is the method which is slightly different from the previous one. In the previous one, we have only read a dot read of CS. So we will read all the characters into CS. But here we have three arguments. CS is the character array. 0 is the starting position in the character array. And 20 is the how many characters we are going to read from the file. So we are going to read the 20 characters from the file. And then just we are just printing it. You can check it by running the program. Okay, just count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. So the 20 characters are read from the file. So once again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, and 20. So the only 20 characters are read from the file. In the input file, we have more number of characters because this is an input file. So we have more number of characters, but only 20 characters are read from the file, and which is returned at the from the beginning of the character array, because we have declared a 20 character size array and is returned at the beginning of the character array. You can change it. So if I want to write the character array from the 10th position, I change it to 10. Okay, just run it. Look at here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it starts from the 11th position, right? So that's a reader class. So reader class with specific arguments. So we can specify how many characters. Okay, one more thing I will demonstrate. So instead of 20 characters, I am going to write. So I want only this welcome. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I'm going to change it to 7. Check it output. So check it. Only currently it reads only the welcome. So we can give constraints here. Okay. So it's clear about the three methods which is available: the simple read class, read into a character array, read the specific value from the file and into the specific position. And next, skip. So skip is, we have already demonstrated skip in the input file input stream reader. So similar, we can skip the number of characters in reading. So here I've given the skip as 7. So just run it. So it skips the first 7 characters from the file and the remaining characters are read by the program. Okay. So change it to 10 and run it. So now it skips first 10 characters including the space. Space is also considered as a character. So it skips the 10 characters from the input stream. So if we have program, if we need, in sometimes we in our program logic we need such skip functions. So in the next video we'll look into the working examples of the previous university questions videos. So I will explain all this use of all these functions there. Anyway, we can use the function based upon our requirement, our logic. We can select the appropriate methods. Okay. So that's about the methods in the file reader class. So next, Java file writer. So similar to the file output stream class, we have a file writer class, and the file writer class is also available in the Java IO package, which is used to write data into the file in form of characters. So the write methods which is available in the file writer class helps us to write the contents into the file. In the file output stream also, we have discussed about the four main constructors. So here also we have the four constructors. Based upon the input, whether it is available in string or file, we have two constructors, file writer, file, file writer, string, file name. And also we have two more constructors, which is used to write the data in the append mode. Because if you open a file writer in this mode, it is created as a fresh. So if there is an already existing file, we are going to open an already existing file in this mode. If you are already, if you are going to write into a file which is already existing in this mode, it overwrite the existing file. All the contents in the existing file will lose. But if you are going to write into a file by using this constructor, it will not overwrite. It appends the new contents into the existing contents. So the existing contents will be retained in the file. So that's the difference between the these two. Similarly here also. So if we specify a string name, if we specify the file name as a string and we use to create, open the file by using the file writer, then it also overwrites the contents of the file. But if you open like this, it will append the existing contents. We look into the working in the Eclipse platform. Okay, just close it. We don't want these files, and we are going to open here where it is. Yes, this is the file writer demo one class, and we are going to write one by one character at a time. Okay, so this is an example for the file write. Here, similar to the read, we are using to read one by one character from the file. So the simple write statement also used to write one by one file into the. Okay, so just look at here. So we are going to write one by one at a time. So just comment it. Okay, run it. So the program is executed. We can open it. The name of the file is file.txt. Open file.txt. Yes, here the 65 is the ASCII value of the capital A letter. So continuous 66 is the capital ASCII value of B, ASCII value of C, so which is written in the file A, B, C. Okay, so we can write one by, also we can write the string constants also into the file. So next we are going to write this EFG into the file. What happened? Yes, the EFG is written into the file. Okay, so ABC and EFG written into the file. So I've given a slash in because I want to write this in the next line. So if you remove the slash in, it will print it in the same line. Just run it. So the ABC and EFG will be sub one at a time, whether it is string constant or it's a character constant. So we can write one at a time by using the simple write statement. Okay, so simple write by using int c, or by simple write by using the string, which is demonstrated in this program. Okay, so first we demonstrated by using the int c, by using write 65, write 66 and write 67, and second we write it by using the string EFG. Okay, if you want to write it in the next line, we have to give it as a slash in. Slash in means the next line, new line character, and when we run this program, the content will be written into the next line. So here the content is written in the next line. Okay, clear. Very good. Okay, so next, if you want to write a character byte into a file, we can use the next method. Okay, look at here. So this is a character array. This is a file and demo using character array, and this is a string, and we have to convert it into the character array. So to character array function, which converts a string into a character array. So a string is converted into character array by using this character array method, two dot character array, which is available in the IU class. So we converted the string. This is file writer demo using this string is converted into the character array by using two character array function, which is available, QA character array method, which is available in the file.io. And we write all the characters in a single statement. So this single statement will write this much of characters into the file at a time. Okay, just run it. So here also we are importing the file writer and IO exception. Just run it. Yeah, now the file input file.txt is return with this data. This is a file writer demo using write character array, which is written by using the character write function, the character array write function. Okay, so by using these statements, by using the character array statement, here data is in a character array. Just look at here. This is a character array. We converted the string into the character array by using this two character array state method, which is default method, which is available in the Java built-in library method, which is available there and which is converted into the character array, and that character array is used to write the content into the file. Clear? Okay, so that's all about the file reader and file writer, which is available in the character stream classes category of Java. Okay, so character stream, which is used to handle the characters, which is available in the Unicode format, and this is not able to handle by using the byte stream classes. So we are introduced the character stream classes. In the character stream classes, we have mainly two categories, reader category and writer category. In the reader category, we discussed about one subclass, that is file reader class. And file reader class is used to read the content from the file in the character format. In the file reader class, we have two constructors. One is string constructor, another one is the character constructor. And there we have different read methods. Read one character at a time, read a character array, read specific characters into the specific positions of the character array, and then the skip methods. These are we discussed in the file reader class. Then we have subclass of the writer class, which is a file writer class. And file writer class, we have the write method. We can write the data into the file in the form of character by using write. We can write the one by one character by using the ASCII value of the character, or we can write it by using string constant string values. And next one is write character array into a file by using the write method, which is a special write method which is available in the Java. And the file reader classes may generate the file not found exception. If you are going to open a file which is not available in the system, it generates the file not found exception. And also there is a chance for generating the IO exception, input output exception, because we are handling with the input output. So there's a chance for IO exception. So these two exceptions have to be handled in the reader classes. And in the writer classes, we have IO exception. So we have to use the methods, proper mechanism to handle this exception. So I think all of you just got an idea about what is a file reader and a file writer. So thank you. Thank you for the patient listening. Thank you.